My name is Philippe Blanc. It's a pleasure to present you within the showcase three renewable energy, the pilot two. And there will be a new pilot that will be demonstrated in showcase three as well, just after me. This pilot is about high PV penetration at urban scale. And the pilot, this part of the pilot is centered and focused in Nantes, which is a French city in the northwest. Okay. Okay, so notably thanks to the WP2 co-design sessions and the different types of co-design we have followed, thanks to the Pascal and Raphaël from the WP2, we have organized this pilot around a core service. So let me introduce this pilot, not in the way that is already described in the card ID, but in that way. I think it put a light on the use of the co-design that structure our pilots. So it's about solar radiation. So the solar radiation at top of atmosphere is very well known. And if you want to take into account clear sky atmosphere, dealing with water vapor and ozone and aerosol and pollution, for example, you can use a Copernicus atmospheric monitoring services data about the atmosphere, and we can transform this data with an already operational service called MacClear, provided by SODA. And then it's about the clouds, of course, because it's a very important source of variability, the clouds. If the clear sky can be described at the 50 kilometers every 1 hour, we need a better resolution for the clouds, and for that we are using satellite data, Meteosat second generation data, and we are using also operational CAMS radiation data that can be served by web services. And you provide this, you can get time series since 2004, time series of irradiation at a resolution of 3 to 5 kilometers every 15 minutes. But if you want to describe the variability and the solar potential at urban scale, this is not enough. And the idea of this pilot, in fact, is to provide with a core service, which is about the downscaling at urban scale, let's say 1 meter resolution, and the downscaling at this urban scale of the solar irradiance, and of course, the corresponding PV power outputs. And for that, we need a digital surface model, which is the shape of the buildings and the trees and the roof and every upper structure on the roof. And it is available in France at, let's say, between 10 centimeter to 20 centimeter. And in Nantes, it's available at 10 centimeter. And we need also a digital elevation model for the large scale horizon effect due to the mountain, for example. And this services is a web processing services following the OGC recommendations. And it is installed in the DIAS, the Data and Information Access Services, Wekeo. Okay, so this is this core services. And we have imagined, thanks to the process of Work Package 2, we have imagined different use cases that use this web processing services that transform the solar radiation coming from CAMS in data that can be useful for the urban scale, for the urban scale. So solar mapping and time series at, let's say, 1 minute, 1 meter resolution. Okay, today I will show you a demonstration about a use case for which the user is Insun Wind Trust. It's a French company providing with solar cadastre to help people to develop PV rooftop systems. And they have a business as a relationship between local PV installers, scrutinized for their quality, and citizens that want to see if there is a potential for their roof to provide electricity from PV system on the rooftop. And this use case is exemplified and illustrated through a Jupyter notebook, and I will show you what it is. And we think that this Jupyter Notebook is very easy to appropriate for the people to appropriate and to start with what we are providing, but develop other way of looking at the data, to process the data based on this web processing services. And again, this Jupyter Notebook in this demonstration is installed in the platform Wekeo, not on the same server, but on a different one. And we try to make collaboration between the Jupyter Notebook and the web processing services. So let's go for the use case about PV self-consumption. So we can imagine that Solar Instant Request is providing already operational solar cadastre, but it's only static map of solar irradiation at a yearly basis. And if a potential customer in a given place in Nantes, for example, want to see if it's very interesting, not only in terms of purchase agreements, but in terms of PV self-consumption, he have to compare his own consumption with the time series of PV output to assess the self-consumption ratio and the self-sufficiency ratio, the part of the PV products that is that will be indeed consumed by the citizen, or the amount of PV production that will be in surplus on the grid. Okay, so I will do demonstration now. Okay, so this is, I hope that you are seeing well. So this is the Jupyter Notebook. So it's a mix between text. We can make also figures, static figures, and equation if you want, and a code here in Python. And this code can be run and give some figures and outputs. You have the table of contents of this notebook, and you can see that there are three steps in these notebooks. The first is about the definition of the zone of interest and the request of the core service, the web processing services, to get the high resolution irradiance at the place where you are interested in. And then you have the section about the PV description, what type of PV you want to install, what are the efficiency, etc. And so you will be able to simulate the PV outputs. And then the last part is about the PV self-consumption. So you describe the way you are consuming your electricity in your place. It can be net metering from your own, but in our case, it's a model depending on the type and typology of buildings or place, commercial activities, house, etc., etc. Once we have described this, then you can have outputs and description of the interest of the PV rooftop in your place. So I can look at an example in Nantes. So here it's already processed because of the demo. I have selected a polygon, a time range. Since there is a real-time request to CAMS radiation, we need the user mail used for the registration of CAMS. And once we have done this, we can compute the selection. So it's a 200 square meter of house you can see here. And then there is the web processing service here, where we can get the maps of solar radiation at 1 meter resolution from 2015 to 2019, so 5 years of data at 15 minute resolution. So we have already this data, but I can meanwhile do another computation to see the time for the next step. So I send this, but I can look at the remaining cells of the notebook. So you can see as a first result, the amount of energy you can get from CAMS at 1 meter resolution, every 1 square meter at a yearly basis. So you can see here, for example, that this roof is with two slopes, one towards the south, one toward the north. So there are clearly a place where it is interesting to install PV and not so much interesting to install PV there. You can have a perception of this PV production as an average of the whole polygons. Okay. So I can now define the PV modules with the efficiency and dependency with respect meteorology and air temperature, notably. So I can get the computation of the amount of square meter for a given interest of irradiance. So I can say that I am interested in installing a PV module if the solar radiation is above a certain limit in terms of square of kilowatt hour per square meter at a yearly basis. So I get this PV modules, and this is my PV system, and it corresponds to a 13.5 kilowatt peak PV system here. And then I can compute, some time series of PV output in kilowatts. You can see example of days, 5 days in a row at 15 minutes resolution. And we can, of course, summarize that here monthly basis. Then you have the possibility, once you have described the PV system and its production, you can get the amount of energy you are able to produce as an average is in a year, and it gives you a capacity factor of 12%. This is a standard value for the northwest of France, which is better in the southeast, for example, where we are located. So once we have this PV production and for a given PV rooftop system, here 14.5 kilowatt peak, we have to describe the PV, the electric consumption. So here it's a model, but we can use net metering just like a Linky in France from Enedis, which is the French DSO. And we can, okay, here we have chosen a typical consumption profile coming from a household. So, and once we have done this, a first assessment is the PV self-consumption ratio and the PV self-sufficiency ratio from year to year. So we have 5 years of data. So we have a slight difference between year to year. So it's good to see if we have a certain stability in terms of results for the PV self-consumption. So what we can see is pretty stable. And we can see that we are able to consume, let's say, on average, 85% of the PV production. And this 85% of PV production that we are able to consume corresponds to, let's say, 28% of my world energy electric consumption. So this is two figures that is of interest for the assessment of a PV system for self-consumption. Once we have done this, we can select one given year to do a more precise assessment. So this is the profile, daily profile of electric consumption. So you can see the dependency with respect to temperature, which is very important in France because of electric heating system, which is a majority. And we can see peaks corresponds to the weekend because it's a house model profile. So we can see, for example, 5 days in a row comparing the PV production in red and the energy electric consumption in blue. What is in purple corresponds to the amount of energy that I am able to consume. And the red part corresponds to the excess of PV production that will be sent to the grid. Okay, so this day I am able to consume all the energy, but I have to import this part of energy. Of course, during the night, I have to import energy from the grid. So exports, imports, and self-consumption. Once I have done this type of things, I can, with very simple model of the cost of electricity coming from my PV rooftop, here it's a 9 cents of euro per kilo watt hour. It's a levelized cost of energy. It's a standard for personal rooftop system, but it can be less, much less, depending on the region. You can also have the cost when you want to sell your surplus of PV production to the grid. Here it's 10 cents per kilowatt hour. And also, if you have to import electricity from the grid, we have to pay it. And the average in France is 18 cents per kilowatt hour. We can also assess the CO2 equivalent per kilowatt hour in the life cycle analysis perspective. So in France, for the grid and the energy mix, it corresponds to more or less 100 kilogram CO2 equivalent per kilowatt hour. And the PV system based on a LCA analysis, including all the from the cradle to the grave analysis, it corresponds to 38 gram kilowatt CO2 equivalent per kilowatt hour. So once we have done this, we can compute the amount of PV self-consumption, the PV self-sufficiency. You can estimate also the gain in terms of money, because you are selling, you are not buying all your electricity from the grid. So you can gain here more or less 1,000 euros per year. And you can see the gain in terms of decrease of kilogram per CO2 equivalent per year because of your PV self-consumption. In that way, you are able to see the relevancy of your PV rooftop system compared to your real consumption, energy, electric consumption.
Philippe, and you can get three more minutes.
Okay, thank you very much. So this is the end of my demonstration. So you can see at the monthly basis, this is my PV my electric consumption, my need of imports of electricity from the grid, my PV self-consumption, and the surplus. Here you can see that we don't need storage for our purpose because the amount of surplus is not so large. Okay, this is the demo. And I can come back if I go to the conclusion. Okay, so sorry. And if I look at the outputs, this is of interest also here. I can look at the output here. And you can see that we are following the standard of NetCDF with climate and forecast metadata, providing all the information you need to use this data. Your, of course, the geometric projection, the time reference, but also the institution, the summary, abstract, all the metadata you need to use this this data for your own purpose. Okay, so as a conclusion and perspectives, what we think that eShape framework and the work packages really helps to structure our pilots. So we have discovered and structured our pilot around web processing services as a core service. And this core service is supported by JAS here, Wekeo. We have made some experiments with Wekeo, and now we have a much better understanding of JAS proposals and costs, especially for Wekeo. And now we have a better idea in terms of cost and usage models that will be very necessary inputs for business and sustainability studies in Work Package 5. We have an operational prototype, including Jupyter-based front-end and core computation of the web processing services based on Wekeo. And this can be used to investigate new users for new usage following the type 4 co-design process described by Work Package 2. So we are planning to use it for Total Energies, which are interested, and some fee for energy building, especially for a specific case about solar radiation impinging the building surfaces, not only the roof. So we are changing a little bit the way we are interfacing the pilot to do this type of computation. And of course, we have the two other use cases that are already identified with users that still to be explored. So the PV variability for the grid, for the point of view of distribution system operator, here Enedis as users, and PV forecasting and short-term forecasting for efficient PV energy trading at urban scale. Thank you very much for your attention. And you have to know that we have a demo, a video of a demo that is available at this YouTube address. And this demo has been done during a solar training that we are doing every year with Soda Transvalor. Thank you very much.